Man. Didn't clean the pain away, but that felt good. Damn. You look bad. Gotta change that dressing soon. Karen seems to be on the move quite often. Wonder how long Karen has been here. Did she see one of Daniel's miracles? So Karen did check it out. Wonder if she saw Daniel in action. Kinda pretty. Wonder if she made it. I know I shouldn't peek, but damn. Karen does like to capture the world around her. Karen did her own road trip to get here. Glad to know she learned the lesson. This country is just way too big. At least Daniel's alive. But he seemed different now. Be right back. Jeez. It only took Supermom 8 years to give a shit. This place is quite remote. Good. At least nobody will be looking for me here. Karen. Karen was always into low-tech. I even think it's the one she had back then. This thing is killing my back. I got bruises on my bruises. Time to hit up Jacob. Huh. This isn't her tablet. Hey, technology. She came prepared. Reverend Mother doesn't look too humble. Looks like a roach motel. But nobody will find me there. I'm not going out. Better wait for Karen in here. We've come a long, long way, buddy. Jacob, it's me, Sean.
Sean? No way! I've been waiting to hear from you for months! So you found my note in your sketchbook?
Yeah.
Where are you? You have to come here, Sean.
I know. I'm not far. In a motel.
Good. Listen, I can't talk right now. I gotta go.
Wait! Daniel, how's he doing?
Meet me tomorrow afternoon on Brandy Highway. There's a junction just above Haven Point. There's a wild mice ranch billboard there. I'll be there at 4.
Jacob, wait!
I can't talk, Sean. Be there tomorrow. Please.
Damn. He couldn't really talk. All this is so messed
up. I really
should finish reading this someday. I'm so drained. Let's just rest while I wait for her. If she comes back.
Hey, sorry it took so long. Fucking store was packed. How you feeling? Nothing broken? Altar boys don't fight fair?
Yeah. I'm okay.
Double cheese, no onion, right?
That'll do.
Got you some gauze and antibacteria stuff for your eye. Hey, don't wolf that down. Or at least take a breath.
Like you care.
Sean, I do.
Come on, Karen. Don't act all hurt. It's too late. Where were you when I broke my leg when I was 13? Not with me. When Daniel got a bad flu a couple years ago, you didn't sleep next to him every night. Where were you? Where were you?
Fair enough. So let's talk, because we do have to get your brother out of a cult.
I'm listening.
How did you two survive alone on the road for that long?
We just got lucky. And got some help along the way. Total strangers. We even had our own little family.
Good. How did you go to Beaver Creek?
You know I don't have to answer your questions, right?
You're right. So tell me what you want from me, Sean.
Nothing, Karen. I mean, what do you want from me? A fucking hug?
Hey, I just want you to know what I did. And why. If you care. So, ask me anything.
All right. Why did you bail on us?
I wasn't meant to be a wife or a mother. I thought I was supposed to. I tried to pretend for many years. But I was unhappy. And the urge to leave just became unbearable. I had no other choice.
Are you serious? You chose this life. You fell in love. You made your own choices, right?
Making your own choices doesn't mean you can never fool yourself, Sean. After I had Daniel, you were about 8, and Esteban's garage was getting busy. There was so much going on around me, yet somehow I just felt that my own life was just slipping away. Felt like an empty shell. Sean, it was the hardest decision I ever made. I knew I might never see you all again, but I took that responsibility.
Did Dad know about all of this?
I was honest with your father. We did family therapy, but it wasn't about him. It was me.
He was heartbroken for months after you left. Years.
I was too. I was in love with your father. He was the best person I ever met.
But just not enough for you.
Something was missing from the equation, yeah. I was.
So what exactly are you doing in Nevada? You live around here?
No. I'm way out in Arizona. Sean, I told you. Your friend Jacob wrote my P.O. box and said Daniel was in trouble. That's it.
Arizona? Holy shit. It's just lizards and rocks.
Guess I found something there. New York didn't really do me good, so...
Yeah. Okay. Think I've heard enough.
I didn't have a choice, Sean. We only have one life. And I didn't want mine to be spent in regrets. For years, I fooled myself. Thinking I'd find satisfaction into what society expected me to be, and that was my mistake. I hope someday you can understand that. But I never stopped caring about you. For what it's worth, I am sorry for hurting you and Daniel, and Esteban.
Oh, please. It's too fucking late for that shit. No matter what, you left your own kids and my dad. So don't even...
I know it's too late. I want you to know how I feel.
Yeah. I still don't care. Jeez.
Sean, whatever you want to say to me, this is the time. Let's just get it all out in the open, see what happens.
Why do you want to talk about all this shit now? I don't care. You were gone for 8 years. Then you get one weird letter, and you jump into action to save Daniel? Is that all it took?
If I didn't step up to help him now, I couldn't live with myself. Esteban hated when I smoked. He didn't want me to die an early death. Fuck. Life can be so cynical sometimes.
I remember he would smoke sometimes. Long ago.
We didn't fight much. But when we did, I would go out on the porch and light up so I could calm down. Esteban would come over and ask for a drag. Now we just look up at the sky and watch the stars. Or the planes. I do miss that.
I used to do the same with my best friend Lila. Sitting on the porch. Just letting time go.
That's when you know someone is good to you. When you can just sit together. Shut the hell up and watch the universe do its own thing.
We should go back inside. I gotta change this dressing.
Okay. Let's go. Sean, I know I can't change the past. Or what I did, but this is about helping your brother. You gotta trust me this one time.
No, I don't. Not after what you did. But yes, we have to be a team to rescue Daniel.
We can do it.
Okay. How?
We need to get in touch with this Jacob. He obviously knows a lot more than us about the church.
Well, I called him when you were out. We can meet with him tomorrow.
Okay, good. I also got these, just in case.
Okay. Better take care of the eye.
So, you feel like telling me the story here?
Not really.
Gotcha. Here, try this on.
How do I look?
Great.
Thanks.
Big day tomorrow, so we should get some rest.
Yeah. I'm ready to get Daniel.
Sure he's gonna show up?
He better. He promised.
Well, if he doesn't find us, we'll find him. I can't believe how much crap you guys have been through. Makes me want to punch in the face each and every asshole that got in your way.
Yeah. Good thing we got to meet amazing people, too.
Life on the road is all about that. The sweet encounters.
Hope I can see them again someday.
Oh, you will. So tell me about Daniel. What's he like?
Well, he's definitely special.
Hope so. He's your brother, right? Heads up. Is that him?
Yep. Wait here. Sean! What happened? Jake. I'm not mad, but you better explain everything.
I didn't know where else to go. Listen, I saw Daniel come back to the camp that night. Like, he was in shock or something. Then I heard all these sirens and I got scared. I packed a few things, I took a blanket from your tent, and we left together. I also kept the cash you made on the farm. It's in my car.
You did right, Jake. Thank you.
You have no idea what he looked like when I found him that night, Sean. He was in bad shape, with a gunshot wound, and all by himself. I I couldn't just leave him there.
So, you came back here after you escaped, but with a dazed little boy, and everybody was cool with that?
Trust me, it was not an easy thing for me to come back. And, yeah, they took us in. That's what they do here. They take people in.
Except they didn't want to take me in yesterday.
I'm telling you, to be careful with the Reverend Mother. She's waited her whole life for somebody like Daniel. The Reverend knows how to manipulate people. She's good at this. He wants to stay with her. Daniel has faith in the Reverend now.
Did you even try to stop her?
Sean, stop it. Why did you think I wrote to your mother? Come on. There's no way they're gonna let you take him away.
Well, too bad. We're not gonna ask for their permission. You must be Jacob. I'm Karen. Hi.
Okay. I don't know if you want to do this, but I have an idea. I think school must be over by now, but Lisbeth will stay at the church with Daniel for his special classes. That'll give us time to sneak into the compound before we get to them.
I'll be on the lookout. Keep watch in case it all goes to shit. Sean, stay on the walkie.
Sounds like a plan.
One more thing. We have to get my sister, too. Sarah Lee.
Really, Jacob? Come on, man. She's with your parents.
I know. Please, listen, Sean. She's not safe here. She's sick. They believe in everything Lisbeth says. And she says she'll cure Sarah with prayers. I know you understand, right?
Damn, Jake.
We need his help too, Sean.
Okay, Jake. I'm listening.
Lisbeth knows what's wrong with Sarah Lee. We need to find her medical record. I think it's in her home office. Then I'll go get Sarah Lee while you get Daniel. Okay?
Fine.
Sure.
I'm gonna trust you on this, Jacob. All good for you, Karen.
What if Daniel won't go with you?
He will. I know him. Karen?
I'm in place. I can see the whole camp. Let me know if you need anything. Be careful, Sean.
Got it. Thanks.
We gotta be careful now. If anything happens, let me do the talking, okay?
Yeah, of course. Let's get this over with.
Okay. Elizabeth's house is right behind the church, so in and out.
Okay. And you sure Lisbeth will have those files on your sister?
Watch out, Sean. There are people right outside.
Oh, shit. How many?
Just three. A man with his kid on one side, and a woman alone on the other.
Got it. Thanks.
People aren't supposed to come and go around the church once the service is over. Better to avoid them if we can.
Karen, Everything all right?
Yeah, don't worry about me. I found the best hiding spot. The view is kind of great.
So, did you grow up out of here?
No. In another community back east. When Lisbeth came out here to start Haven Point, my folks followed her and brought me along.
Must have been hard on you.
Kinda. 8-year-olds don't want to go to church all day. Okay. There it is. Looks empty.
Let's hope so.
Luckily for us, we never close our door. A closed door is a closed heart, she says.
Can't believe Daniel really lives in this depressing house.
Oh, we did it. Now we have a little bit more time.
Yes, we do. Nice work. So where are the files?
Right there, in her office. Of course it's locked. Her open door speech is just another lie. We gotta find a way in.
Fuck. Think there's a key somewhere?
Maybe she's too cautious not to have a spare set around. Whoa.
Evenings in here must be so much fun. Are you okay, Jake? Lisbeth sure likes to be on pictures.
Yeah. Yeah, no. It's just so full of memories and stuff.
Damn. This is so artless. Coaxing lesson one. Get Daniel his favorite cereal. Whoa. This place is worse than army camp. Might be enough to open that door.
Sean, hey, you think that's a good idea?
Hell yeah.
Perfect.
Whoa. Is this her personal archive or something?
Yeah. She keeps track of everything in here. Stuff about my sister must be in this one.
Okay, I've got something. Must be what you're looking for.
Damn. She has pneumonia? And for what I get, Lisbeth knows damn well she needs medical treatment.
That's criminal. She's insane. Look, she has a file on you, too.
You can take a peek and see how she really treats her flock.
Man, what's all this? Were you, like, sick? Conversion therapy? Did they wanted to cure you from being...
Pretty much. I always showed more interest in boys than girls. They thought I was a freak. A sinner.
Didn't you tell your parents?
You kidding? They wanted her to do that. Mom and Dad thought I had a demon inside. So did I. I really did believe I was a sinner, so I thought I had to atone for my sins.
And, how did that go?
Not good. I just prayed all the time and stopped hanging out with boys, girls, everybody. I got depressed, paranoid.
Damn, Jake.
After a few years, I was in a really bad place. I tried to hurt myself. Elizabeth was very upset. We had a long chat. She told me I should leave. Go see the world and figure things out. I don't really get her, Sean. But Elizabeth does believe in all of this stuff.
I had no clue about your life here. I'm sorry, Jake.
I'm sorry I brought Daniel here. I was just so blown away when I saw what he could do. It was like a real miracle. I thought I'd found my faith again. Instead, I just hurt him.
Then let's make things right. We just have to get Daniel out of here.
I hope so. And I'll get my sister to a hospital, have her treated. I hope they'll help her.
Yeah. Anything would be better than here.
Right. I just hope they can still cure her.
Sean, are you there?
What's up?
You got company. That thug who works for Elizabeth, he's just holding some files. Doesn't seem to be on to you.
This guy is dangerous, Sean.
Hey,
trust me.
I have a good plan to get him out of your way. He'll give you more time. Just give me the word.
No. It might be too dangerous. We'll figure it out.
Okay. But be extra careful, please.
Sean, we gotta hide. Now. Hurry up. Come on, Sean, we need to hide. Man, if he finds us here, we're screwed.
What the? Hello? Is someone there?
What are you doing here, punk? Huh?
Stop! Let him go, Nicholas! Ah!
You're trespassing too, you little fag. You were always trouble. I'll deal with you later. Now come with me, you shithead.
Oh, Lord. Let your power speak through this young vessel. Speak to me.
Reverend!
Sean! What's going on?
Reverend, He was going through your stuff in your office. Jacob let him in, but I took care of that, Judas.
Oh, Sean. Little lost lamb. How could you desecrate holy land?
Sean! You okay? Huh?
Yeah. Don't worry. Come with me, Daniel. We're leaving.
I'm sorry, Sean. I can't.
She's full of shit, dude. And she's using you.
Daniel has made his choice, Sean. But I'm offering you to join us again. Put your faith in me, and you'll be family.
Never.
So that's your final decision. May the Lord have mercy on your lost soul. It's time for you to leave our sanctuary. Right now.
Not without my brother.
Didn't you hear the Reverend?
Nicholas! Sean is just confused. We forgive the sinners.
I'm not going anywhere. This is my home. She's my family now.
Daniel, listen. She's not your family.
Sean, who is she?
Our mother. She came here. For you.
Oh, praise the Lord. Another miracle at our church. Wonderful. It's all right, Daniel. Go see her. I mean, she's right there. Don't be afraid.
I don't know her.
Of course. I know. This is hard for you, my son.
Stop calling him that. You're just manipulating him, you sicko.
That's in the eye of the beholder. But since you are his mother, let me ask you. How could you let your child wander alone in the wilderness? Where were you when Daniel was lost? Where?
Listen, Daniel. I came here as soon as I found out you were here on your own.
I'm not on my own.
Children are a gift from the Lord. They are a reward from Him. You were blessed with a divine gift. And you cast him out into the world.
Who the hell are you?
You might have been his mother once, but when you abandoned him, you also gave up your rights.
Isn't your God all about forgiveness?
You have no idea what the Bible says. How can you pretend to care about these two children? You left them and your husband to seek out your base desires.
Daniel, honey, she's trying to trick you. Please, think by yourself. You're smarter than this.
Daniel, she's responsible for what happened to your father.
You don't know anything. It was an accident. That's what this world is about. Accidents, injustice, pain.
I'm just so sorry, Daniel.
I know. I know how much I hurt you and your brother by leaving. I know that's not enough, but I hope we can talk about this together. That's what I've been trying to tell your brother, and I'm so glad he listened. You gotta trust us. She's using you for her selfish desires.
Daniel, this time the choice is yours. Are you going to believe her, or me?
I...
That's right. You can't tempt Daniel from this garden. He'll stay with us, his true family. And we'll never leave him.
Go to hell. Come on, Daniel.
No!
Holy shit. Okay, what now?
Don't you understand? This is over, Sean.
You have to talk to him. You can convince him, Sean.
I won't leave you, Daniel. Not here.
Don't be so stubborn, Sean. Your brother chose his path.
Your friend, Sarah Lee, she's very sick. And Lisbeth won't take her to a doctor.
What? She wouldn't do
that.
This
is pointless. Daniel knows who to trust.
Don't listen to her religious bullshit. You need to have faith in yourself, not in her.
But you said heaven and God existed. Why are you lying?
You're right. He's wicked, unfaithful.
This is a toxic community. She's cutting everyone from the world, keeping things secret. She wants to keep you to herself.
It's better like that. At least I'm not hurting anyone anymore out here.
You found your home here, Daniel. Don't let him trick you.
Come on, Daniel. I know you're smarter than this. Don't tell me you're buying her crap.
I bought yours many times. And looked at everything it's got me into. See what you have done.
Hey, Inanno.
Back off.
No one is gonna keep me away from you.
I said stop!
Don't. I came all this way for you, and nobody will stop me. I'll even cross hell or whatever if I need-
Sean!
He must learn.
Listen. I did my best job to be a good brother. And I know I probably failed. I took you for granted. I put you in danger. And I'm sorry.
Sean!
Don't listen to him.
He left you just like that harlot did. Shut him up.
He can hit me as much as he wants. I won't give up on you.
Don't hit him.
Don't let them do that, Daniel.
If I could go back in time, I would. We'd be in our living room in Seattle. Dad would get us pizza and snacks, then pick the movie, because we would always fight about it. And he always picked your movie. But I can't do that. All I can do now is fight.
Quiet! What are you waiting for?
We're the best team in Anno.
Stop
it! So we have to keep going
forward. What are you
doing? You're gonna kill him!
Please! He's my brother!
You can burn down our church, but not our faith.
Daniel knows you're telling the truth.
Don't give up.
Nothing is gonna stop me, Daniel. We're brothers.
I know.
Dad always said our blood link was the most important thing. You know.
Please! Stop! Leave him alone!
Daniel! Listen to him!
I won't stop, no matter what she does. I'll come right back, again and again. I love you, Daniel.
I do too. Shut him up! Now!
Don't move! Just stop!
If you want to kill me, then do it! I'm not afraid!
Do it! Shoot! Don't!
Go ahead!
What?
Shoot me in the face! And live with me!
Now! Stop! She was someone else. I'm sorry.
Sean,
We need to get out of here. Now.
Oh, no. No. You started this fire. You will all burn in this hell.
Move. Let us go. Move it!
You won't leave this place. Not with me alive.
Open the door, Inan.
Daniel, after all I did for you, you can still repent.
I don't believe you anymore!
But someday you understand.